have an exciting announcement to make today. We have a visitor. Isn't that nuts? Yes, it is, Sydney. What do we say to our visitor? We say, good morning, visitor. No, Peggy, our visitor hasn't got a funny hat on. That's her hair. I'm so sorry. We are a trifle outspoken here sometimes. Well, you seem to have caught us in the middle of a free activity period. And in our free activity period, each little individual chooses his or her own form of occupation. So you come out to one of that table, please. Yes, some of us paint, some of us do plaster scene, and there's a sand table over there. Yes, we feel it's important that each individual must get to the bottom of himself and find what he really wants from life. Who is making that buzzing noise? Well, stop it, too, Laurel. But Hazel, they come away from that door. Oh, I do so love to see them so happily occupied. Each one expressing himself. George, don't do that. This is my good friend Caroline. And Caroline's painting such a lovely picture, aren't you, Caroline? I wonder what it is. Is it an orange, perhaps, or a sunset? Oh, it's a picture of Mummy. Oh, well, for a minute there, I thought it was an orange, but now that you tell me, yes, see, it's a picture of Mummy. Aren't you going to give her nose? No nose. You know, I find it so interesting the way that you see. Sydney, stop blowing at Edgar. Yes, I know I said you could choose your activity, but blowing at Edgar is not one of them. Because I don't think it's a good idea. Well, because I'm not going to argue with you, Sydney. Go and sit next to Susan at a sand table. Yes, there is room, Sue. There's heaps of room. Just move up. Susan, we never bite our prey. Now say you're sorry, Sydney. No, you needn't kiss him. You needn't hug him, Susan. Put him down. I'm afraid our egos are written on the large side, Miss Single. Hazel, dear, I remember to tell you again, come away from that door. Well, why can't you? Well, if you didn't put your finger in, it wouldn't get stuck, would it? Children, there's no need for you all to come and have a look at poor Hazel. Back to your seats. David, turn around, please, David. Right round. Oh, use a hanky. And again. And again. And what? Thank you, David. Now, Hazel, dear, why didn't you put your finger in the keyhole? To see if it would go in. Let's take a look, shall we? No, Sydney, I don't think Hazel's finger will be stuck there forever and ever. Well, I shouldn't think for a minute the fire brigade will have to come and take the drawer down. You don't exaggerate. Well, if we haven't got a finger out by dinner time, then she'll have to have a dinner here, won't she? Yes, and her tea, and her supper and stay at night, but we're going to test it out. Who is making that buzzing noise? Neville. I don't want to have to tell you again. Yes, I know you are busy, Bee, but I don't want to hear you buzzing. No, not even quietly. I can still hear you, Neville. Neville. I don't think so. Now then, Hazel, let's take a look. Oh, that really is stuck, isn't it? Oh, you know, Mrs. Single, that child's finger really is stuck in the keyhole. Well, I think Fire Brigade is the best in the circumstance. Oh, yes, I've got their number in my office. Oh, would you? Oh, I'm most grateful. Now, children, I want you to be very grown up. One of those nice firemen are going to cut it. Oh, you've got it out! Oh, that's wonderful! Oh, Mrs. Lincoln, she's got it out! Oh, Sydney, you almost go near that door. Sydney!
Oh, what have you got?
Oh, I spoke too soon, Mrs. Hingle.
Oh, Cindy.